In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to import a set of bracketed photographs into Photomatix Essentials RE, and then onwards to rendering and saving your image. If you haven't watched the video tutorial which shows how to photograph an interior with a bright window, then I suggest that you do so first. It explains a simple technique that you can follow when taking the bracketed photos that I will use in this tutorial. When you open Photomatix Essentials RE, the first window has a help section on the left-hand side. But for now, let's move over to the right-hand side of this window. Loading your photos is easy. Here on the right are two options. Firstly, there's the classic Browse button. Click on this and a file window appears. You will need to navigate through folders inside this window until you find your photos. Once located, click on the first file with your mouse, and then press and hold down the Control key. Whilst holding down the Control key, click all the other photos in the set using your mouse. Then click Open to load your photos into Photomatix Essentials. Or there's the drag and drop facility. By going directly to your image, file or folder on your computer, press and hold down the Control key. Left click your mouse and highlight your photos. Then simply drag them into Photomatix Essentials. Remember, if you have taken a set of bracketed photos, then the whole set of bracketed photos should be imported together. Once imported, you will see that the display changes. Your set of bracketed photos have appeared with ticks alongside them. If you wish to exclude a photo from the merging process, then simply untick it. But for now, leave them all ticked and we'll carry on with the photos you have imported. Photomatix Essentials also acts as a friendly quality control inspector too. Click on the Check Photos box and Photomatix will advise you on a number of technical features, such as the levels of brightness and darkness in your photos. I should point out that this step isn't compulsory. It's more for feedback on the quality of your photos, but useful if you'd like to learn how to improve your technique. Now move down to the bottom right of this window and click Next, Merge and Adjust, and Photomatix Essentials will blend your bracketed photos together into a single low-resolution image. You will be able to fine-tune and make adjustments once it's finished. To the right of the Step 2 window, you will find a collection of one-click presets. Try different presets and choose a style that you like. Clicking on a thumbnail shows the effect of the preset in the preview. Once you have found a preset that you like, you can refine the effect by adjusting the settings sliders on the left-hand side. For instance, move the shadows slider to the right and the dark areas of the image become brighter and darker when you slide to the left. Once you are happy with the adjustments, click on the Next, Finish and Save button and Photomatix will then render the image at original resolution. You are now at the last step, the Finish and Save window. At this point, there are a few more adjustments that you can make. On the left-hand side, you will find Sharpen and below that, Contrast. Sharpen, as the word suggests, will sharpen the edges and lines in your image. Click on the Sharpen pull-down menu and select Medium to see what happens. Pay close attention to your outlines and edges, but don't go too far. The contrast adjustment is directly underneath. Low contrast images look flat or dull, whereas high contrast will brighten the highlights, but can also darken your shadows. Select Mild Contrast and see what happens to your bright and shadowed areas. Again, don't go too far. Now we move down to Save with Size. If you're uploading your image to MLS, then you can choose the standard or high-res size. Both of these sizes have a 4:3 aspect ratio, which is the ratio used by MLS systems. Let me explain aspect ratio. Typically, a photograph from a camera has an aspect ratio of 3:2. That's 3 wide by 2 down. However, MLS systems use images that have an aspect ratio of 4:3. That's 4 wide by 3 down. If you resize your image to fit the standard or high-res MLS, the image aspect ratio will then change from 3:2 to 4:3, and the image will look distorted. So to avoid this, use the crop tool to crop the image so it fits into a 4x3 frame. To do that, click on the crop tool and make sure that the used fixed ratio 4x3 box is checked. Then click on the image and drag your mouse across it to draw a 4x3 frame. When you are happy with the cropped frame, click Apply. If you're not happy with the result, then simply click Undo Crop and start over. But for now, we'll carry on. All you need to do is to save your finished image. Click on Save, then decide where you want the image to be saved and point the Save As panel towards it. Your image has now been saved, and to find it, navigate to the folder you chose to save the image. You can download a free trial of Photomatix Essentials RE by following this link.